Welcome back. Hope you're doing well. Today we have this trigonometry problem, and in that we have a triangle. Triangle name is PQR, and one side length of this triangle is given, which is 11. What we have to do, we have to find out perimeter of this triangle PQR. But before starting, you are requested to please thumbs up and share this solution with your friends. Now let's get started and see how we can find out the perimeter. In this triangle, we can see that one side length is given and we have to find out the other two. So first of all, let's name these sides as A, B and C and make sure A, B, C are the real number. So in this triangle, we can see that PQ, which is B here, is equal to 11, and angle PQR is 90 degree. So we have to find out the perimeter and we have to find the other two sides A and C. Then we can find out the perimeter, which is the summation of all three sides. So basically we have to find out the two sides A and C, and then we can find out the perimeter. So there we are going to use Pythagorean theorem. By using Pythagorean theorem, A square plus B square is equal to C square. A square as it is, B is given here 11, so 11 square is equal to C square. Here we are going to subtract A square on both sides of this equation, C square minus A square. A square cancel out, 11 square is equal to C square minus A square. Right hand side of this equation is same like algebra identity. It is as same as a square minus b square, and we can write it as a plus b times a minus b. So by writing this equation, 11 square is equal to c plus a times c minus a, and 11 square is equal to 121. C plus A times C minus A. And keep this thing in your mind that C plus A greater than C minus A. Now 121 is as same as 121 times 1. 121 times 1 and 11 times 11, which is equal to C plus A times C minus A. And 11 times 11 is C plus A times C minus A. Let's name this as case 1 and case 2. We are going to simplify both cases one by one. First of all, this one, case 1, 121 is equal to C plus A, and 1 is equal to C minus A. From here we can see 1 is equal to C minus A. This is case 1. Let's add these two equations. So this A and A cancel out. This is equal to 122 is equal to 2C. Now by dividing both sides by 2, 122 divided by 2 is equal to 2c by 2. 2 and 2 cancel out. We have 61 is equal to c. So we got the value of c, which is equal to 61. Now by putting this value of c in any of the equation, 1 is equal to 61 minus a. 61 is the value of c. A is equal to 61 minus 1. So A is equal to 60. It means we also got the value of A. From there we have A B and C values, but we have to try the another case, which is case 2. 11 times 11 is equal to C plus A times C minus A. From there we can see that 11 is equal to C plus A, C plus A is equal to 11, and C minus A is also equal to 11. If we add these two equations, AA cancel out, 2C is equal to 11 plus 11 is 22. Dividing both sides by 2, we got 2 and 2 cancel out. C is equal to 22 divided by 2 is 11. So C is equal to 11. By putting this value of C in any of the equation, 11 plus A is equal to 11. A is equal to 11 minus 11. So A is equal to 0. We got the value of A is equal to 0, which is not applicable. So we are going to neglect this case because value of A cannot be 0. So by case 1, we got the value of other two sides, side C and side A. Side C is equal to 61 and side A is equal to 60. So we have to find out the parameter, and we are going to use these value of A, B and C in that formula. P is equal to A plus B plus C. Parameter is equal to A, 60, plus B is equal to already given 11, and C is equal to 61. After adding we got 2 and 6, 13, 132. So parameter is basically summation of all three sides, which is equal to 132. I hope you like this solution. If you have any question, any query, write in the comment box. Thanks for watching.